everybody. I'm going to be showing today self facial massage, the Marma Point massage using the Kasa face massage wand. Now, this massage wand is made of Kasa metal, which is from the ancient wisdom of Ayurveda. It's a healing massage, which one, if you start doing it, you'll get addicted to doing it every day. Now, this is a tool which is like based on the Ayurvedic wisdom of the ancient Ayurvedic wisdom, and it has the bell metal as a top, which is the Kasa metal, which is an alloy of copper. Now, this handle was not there initially. In the ancient times, it was used as a katori, and the katori was used to rub. Now, with modern times, for ease of usage, we've added a handle. Now, it's a very ancient tool. It's just like a gift from Ayurveda that is to us, so that we can utilize its wisdom and in this time and age, make the best of our skin and hair with utilizing this tool. What it does is, how does Kasa work? I just want to quickly brief up on that. It just works on a much deeper level. Like the subtle energies in our collagen and our muscle layers, it stimulates that. So stimulating collagen, making the skin much more youthful, firmer, healthier. And then it oxygenates the skin, and it takes away the toxins by dissolving the acid on the skin. Usually Pitta skin has more acid, and so it balances the Pitta dosha, cools down the skin, takes away the toxins, takes away the acidity, alkalizing the skin. And also it works on the prana by freeing the energies which are stagnated in the Marma points. When we do the Marma point massage, you'll be releasing the energies in those points. So once they are freer, they are more, the skin becomes much more healthier, because the prana, that's the subtle life force, it moves freely into those Marma points. Then it also balances the chakras, because few of the Marma points are also related to the energy centers. So that, and then it balances the doshas. So when the doshas are all in balance, you feel a sense of peace. That's what happens. The mind is calm, the stress is taken away. I feel that when I do it in my evenings, that it just quietens my mind. It just puts all that chatter of the mind at rest, which is, or my mind is always trying to tell me something, and it just goes off to a sleep mode. So that is what it does, and balancing, and it makes the skin radiate from within. And the chakras and the Marma points that it works on, the copper is very healthy for the skin. So you're assimilating more copper, and you're also assimilating what you apply into the skin in much deeper layers. So the skin becomes much more healthier and delays aging, and it's good for all age groups. And it also is good for all skin types. So even if an acne prone skin, you can use it, because it will reduce the breakouts, because acne prone skin is more acidic. So it will reduce the acidity, it will reduce the inflammation, it will cool down the skin. And on active acne, you just have to place it for a little while and then remove it. So do not do the rubbing on the active acne, but place it, because the cooling effect of Kasa metal will reduce the infection and the inflammation in the breakout, and it will also cut the oxygen supply, so that the acne or the pimple shrinks. So it works on all kind of skin, all skin types as well. And evening, I prefer to be the best time to do the Kasa Marma Point Kasa massage. But if you want to do it in the morning, you feel free to do that, because in the morning you can do it to depuff your, to reduce the puffiness of your skin. It also makes the skin firmer and reduces the puffiness as well. So, and which oil to use it with? So the best oil is Sri Kamya, because that's what is made by Orya. But then you can use any other oil as well, which is pH balance. Most important, should not have citrus oils, or should not have vitamin C or anything which will react with the Kasa metal and give that gray effect. We are looking at the gray effect from the toxins which are built up in the skin. So it also moves the lymph the stagnated lymph, and it removes the acid accumulation which is deep seated into the skin. So that also the multiple benefits. I can keep talking about the Kansa wand, and you know, it has not got its due recognition, so I want that people should, you know, incorporate it and you know, see the difference for themselves, what it makes to the skin. So let's start with the massage. So first make sure that you have well cleansed face. Prep your skin using the Radharani beauty water. I just prep quickly. I've just put my hair a little back so that I can show you the movements easily. This is Sri Kamya oil. Rub it with, you know, it contains carrot seed oil, almond, sesame, prakchandan, and kasturi manjal, which is very good for depigmentation and improving the skin texture. So whichever oil you want to be deeply assimilated, you should apply that before starting your Kansa massage. Now, marma points are those points which literally mean, marma means to kill, or hidden secrets. So these are those hidden points in your face, which when stimulated will allow the free flow of energy. And you know, you'll feel a lot of difference. This face will light up from within, and there'll be a nice sheen and a radiance on the face. And all that stagnation will open up, and that's about it. So I'm going to be using this Sushrut Samhita's 107. You know, he's laid down 107 points, although their Tamil tradition says 108. You know, Kalahari says 367. So there are many other, but I follow Sushrut Samhita. That's what I've been taught by my teacher. And how to do that, I'm going to just reveal that beautiful secret which was given to me by my acharya, how to do the daily marma point self-healing massage. So one point to notice here is, please do not be very harsh on your skin. Be gentle. Now this wand is not meant to, you know, scrape or something. We're just stimulating the points which are lying deep within, and allowing the free flow, as I said. And that's about it. So let's just start doing this. We start from the forehead, because that is where all the tension is. To relieve the stress and tension, you feel much lighter, and then the face and the body is ready for the rest of the massage. Starting from the center, which is called the Sthapini. Now this point is right here. I'll show you the point each time. In the center of the eyebrows here, where you put the bindi, also called the bindi point, Sthapini. So I'm just stimulating. You can keep rotating it clockwise or anti-clockwise. Do not do over-stimulation also. And press. You will feel with the press, you're able to connect inwards. It's already started with its magic, the Kansa wand. Then I go in circular movements above my eyebrows. Massaging above the eyebrows is also very relaxing, because throughout the day we store a lot of stress here. So I do this draining movement with my two fingers and the Kansa wand into the temples. Now, a couple of times when you've done this, you just drain it into the avrat here. Avrat is the arch of the eyebrow, the bony orbit, not the inner one, the outside bony orbit. Avrat, also known as Ashru Madhya in some texts. I stimulate this as a second marma point, going here to Apanga, which is where the eyebrow ends, a little outwards and downwards. Apanga, this. Clockwise and anti-clockwise. It's not important to go anti-clockwise. You can do clockwise and press also. Then into the temple, which is Shankha. Temple is the hollow, which is everybody knows of. That's called Shankha. You don't have to remember the names, just the placement is important. Then I go on to the other side, opening up the knots of the muscles here above the eyebrows, and a couple of times, and then the avrat, which is the arch of the eyebrow, as I repeated on the left side, and press up. panga, end of the eyebrow and little outwards. And press and into the temple. Press. So now, sliding outwards, going upwards towards the hairline. And this is where uk shape is, near the hairline. This part is uk shape. You can further go into the hairline. Do not do this if you have dandruff or any scalp infection, because you will be pulling it into your face. Very relaxing movements. So I'm going outwards now. Now the number 8 around the eyes. Make sure that you do a outward 8. Outward is going this way. A couple of times. Onto the face. Then let's do the drain. Now drain using the finger into the temple and sideways into the collarbone. Let's start the upper cheek. I take my two fingers and I drag them outwards. I think I need more oil. My skin has already assimilated all the oil I put. So anytime you feel like you need to replenish the oil, please do so. I'm so fond of my Marma Point massage. Here, let's do the upper cheek. You can use two fingers the way I'm using it, or you can even use your entire hand this way, four fingers. Depends on what you find easy, so that will not make any difference. But this way, outwards, 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 firming the jawline. When you're firming the jawline, you should go behind the ear. Behind the earlobe is vidur, in the hollow here. If you lift the lobe, there's a slight hollow, that is which is called vidur. Stimulating this. You know, when what I like doing is a little circular movement and then a gentle press, right? So let's repeat this. You can repeat the movements a couple of times. Upper cheek, I'm taking everything towards the temple. Then from the mouth towards the ears and jaw firming. I'm being a little quick so you can take longer for these movements. Do it for 5 minutes each day, more than enough. Let's do the other side as well. Upper cheek. My skin loves Shrikamya. It just drinks the Shrikamya as if I didn't put any oil. Lower cheek towards the ear and then firming the jawline. Again, middle cheek and lower cheek. Yeah. Now let's do the nose. Now this is where fana is, where the nostrils meet the face here around this area. You stimulate fana. That's another Marma Point. Circular movement and press. Circular movements and press. Then go zigzag on your nose. From side to side, zigzag. couple of times. Once you've done that, on the upper lip. How I do it on the upper lip is from the under of the lip, from the lower lip, you just go sideways and lift it up. Sideways and lift it up. Similarly, on the other side, you still go sideways and you lift it up. Right? And then circular movements on the chin and outwards. Outwards and outwards. Like this. So now the movement that I like doing is, you know, you drag the kansa and you take it to where the cheek muscle starts, here, and stop here. Dragging it upwards against the gravity so that there is no sag over the ears. I'm not going beyond this cheek muscle. That's an important point to notice. I'm just stopping where the cheek muscle starts. So you'll know, if you touch your face, you'll come to know where the cheek muscle starts. So this is where I'm ending. It's a very nice movement to give a nice hold to the skin and to reduce the sag. Because there's a lot of tightness we all hold in the jaw area. Loosen up the jaw. Now which part I'm moving is this part of in front of the ear, clockwise. See, it's opening up what I have, you know, I mean, you can't feel what I'm feeling now. I've been speaking all day, so it relieves all the tension in the jaw. At times I like using two kasa wands because it makes my job quicker. So this, after you've done the side jaw release, the vidur, go on to the neck. Downwards. I'm using four fingers because it's a longer muscle, platysma. So I don't get a graying effect because I use the kansa wand every day. But you know, usually you will get a graying effect, especially initially, and at times it goes lesser, but at times when you've changed your diet or you have you know, used a different product which was rich in vitamin C, or you have, you know, stressed, or you have, you know, environmental changes, you might see the graying effect coming again. Stimulating the kantha here. Kantha is where the Adam's apple is. Do not press hard again. This is where thyroid is located. Clockwise and a gentle press here. Outwards. Outwards. Then what I like doing is knocking my shoulder for releasing all the tension. So this is how I'm holding the kansa. Wand. It's a little hammering sort of a movement to allow a good blood flow into the face and opening up any stress or tension which is there in the shoulders. After this, you know, once you've done the neck massage, you know, you should always go back to the forehead and do the drain again. One more time, do the drain again into the collarbone and end it by establishing the connection again with the sthapani. Like this, you can even do a little more relaxation by number 8 on the forehead, but definitely end on the sthapini. This reconnects. So we've opened up all the marma points and we have made the oil assimilated well. So how do you clean your kasa wand after the massage? is you take a a sulfate free hand wash and you wipe your kasa with it and clean it and then wipe it dry. Store it in the cotton pouch that it comes with. Make sure that you draw the strings nicely so that the opening is sealed and it's not exposed to air so that the metal does not get oxidized each time you use it. And if you want to polish it, so take some wheat flour, like a tablespoon or so of wheat flour, and pinch of salt, and maybe half, 1/4 or half teaspoon of vinegar, and then rub it nicely, and that will polish your kasa wand. Take care of it, use it with care, gently, and do not drop it. It's a delicate tool. And also with regular use on your skin, you will see that with marma point stimulation, the skin radiates from within and it becomes healthier and much more supple and plump. So enjoy your wand and have beautiful skin. Like I haven't, after the massage, I haven't wiped my skin. It's just I let the oil be. But if you feel that it's very oily, you can wipe the oil out. But I like the radiance that oil gives after the kasa massage. So enjoy your beautiful skin and massage each day. Thank you.